Howdy, I'm presenting to you guys on budgeting today and why it's important not only during our years in college, but also life beyond. So first thing first, we're gonna watch a little video on what some misconceptions about budgeting might be.
Suppose you graduate from high school. Let's say you just slide by. All right, now you gotta find a job. Now, what kind of salary do you expect for a regular person?
$250 a week.
$250 a week?
Yeah.
Sit down. I'm going to give you $300 a week. Yes, indeed. $300 a week, $1,200 a month. All right?
Great, I'll take it.
Yes, you will. And I will take $350 for taxes.
Whoa!
Yeah, now, because see, the government comes for the regular people first. Now, how much does that leave you with?
$850.
All right. Now, you've got to have an apartment because you are not going to live here. So, an apartment in Manhattan will run you at least $400 a month.
I'll live in New Jersey.
All right. Live in New Jersey, you've got to have a car.
I ride a motorbike.
You need a helmet. Figure $100 a month for clothes and shoes.
Figure $200. I want to look good.
Okay, so what's that leave you with?
$200. So, no problem.
There is a problem. You haven't eaten yet.
I can get by on bologna and cereal. So, I got everything I need plus $200 left for the month.
You plan to have a girlfriend?
For sure.
Okay, so that in mind, what do you guys think budgeting is? Like, what's your? Okay. Yeah. So a little interaction here. What do you guys think budgeting is?
Budgeting just like assigning your money to a specific area, like, you know, just like send off a specific amount of money for each category of life you go through.
Okay.
Keeping track and hold yourself accountable with your finances.
Okay, that's a good answer. So, budgeting, I want you guys to think of it, so it's not the B word, it's not essentially, some people consider like a financial like swear term, like you're just like, you hate budgeting, no one likes to budget, no one likes to like inhibit where they're spending their money, but that's exactly what it is. Budgeting is a spending plan, and so you're controlling your finances so you can allocate it where it needs to go. Telling your money where to go, so to speak. And so a resource that A&M uses called Salt Money, which I'll get into more in a second, says that a strategy you devise in order to achieve the things you need and want today and become intentional with how you achieve the things you need and want in the future. So that said, a couple things you want to think about when you try and create a budget. So if you're going to start creating a budget for either your time here in college or beyond, you have to know what your income is, you have to know what your savings will be, and you have to know what your expenses are. And so your income is very easily defined as just like the money that you have. And like any kind of income source, it can be, you know, parents, it can be your work, it can be like stock market, literally any kind of positive income money resource. Savings is money you're setting aside for either emergencies or goals. So we'll get into that more in a second, but just think of those two things. And expenses is money that you're gonna spend. This is what a budget is for. And there's also three like main kinds of expenses that we're gonna get into in a second. So again, just to rehash income. Income is the positive. It's the green. It's what we all want. We all want income. And so a budget plan is basically allocating what the income is to the appropriate expenses and savings accounts. So savings, like I mentioned earlier, is money allocated towards emergencies or goals. And so a basic starting point on savings is establishing an emergency fund. So how many of you guys have heard of that beforehand? Alright, Johnson, what is it?
It's basically a set amount of money that you set aside that you're not gonna touch unless it's an emergency.
Yeah, so who can tell me, like, what's a good period of time for an emergency fund to, like, be set up for?
10 years.
10 years? Okay, that's a really long term, but think about just, like, short term.
Like a year?
A year, that's good. So the general rule of thumb is you want 3 to 6 months of living expenses set aside as your emergency fund. So if you lost your job today, you'd have 3 to 6 months where you could get by, you know, find a new job, doing whatever you need to do. And so that's what it's for. And then also, aside from an emergency fund, the next step is then saving for short-term, mid-term, or long-term goals. So what do you guys think might be a short-term goal?
Buying a car.
Okay, that's more of a mid-term goal.
New phone, maybe.
Yeah, something small like that. It could be establishing your emergency fund. So short term is usually defined something under a year, something you can accomplish in a year. So you want to buy this object. You want to have an emergency fund set up so you're good to go. Midterm is something under 10 years. And so you're looking at something like, you know, buying a new car or something like that. A bigger, more substantial purchase, but not something that's like monumental. And long term would be, for most of us, probably just buying a house. And that's the longest and most like profound purchase we're going to make. So now expenses. So there's three kinds of expenses that are really important to differentiate. There's fixed expenses. So these are things that are absolutely necessary. Shelter, emergency funds, transportation, health-related expenses. These are things that every single month are going to stay the same. That no matter what happens, these are they're set in stone, essentially. The next thing is flexible expenses. And this is the same thing in that they're like necessary, but they tend to vary. So food, stuff for your car. You know, your car always needs gas. That's a pretty fixed expense, but how much gas based on month-to-month basis, that may vary. Also, what if something happens to it and it breaks down and needs repairs, that kind of stuff. The last thing is discretionary expenses. And this is the fun stuff. This is what like you want to spend on. This is basically the leftover money that we'll get to in a second. And so that in mind of your income, your savings, your expenses, these are kind of the seven really just inline steps of how to create a budget. So the first thing is you want to gather all this information so you have an idea of like where you are financially, what your the positive and negative is on your balance sheet, so to speak. So you want to figure out what your total income is, stock market, job, tips, everything you have. Subtract what you need to pay out from your fixed expenses. Subtract what your usual flexible expenses are. Subtract your savings, so the emergency fund, and then also the other avenues you want to save towards. Evaluate what you have left for your discretionary expenses. So everything that for the fun stuff, how much you usually spend per month on the fun stuff, and then what's left over. Is it positive? Is it negative? Like, and then reevaluate from there. So that said, those seven steps in mind, here's some practical tips for actually like maintaining the budget, because it's a very good idea to, like, I'm gonna have a budget, I'm gonna follow this, I'm gonna, you know, save money and live within my means. But I don't know if any of you guys ever tried this. It's a pretty hard thing to do, to stick to a budget. So couple quick things to like actually help you guys learn to stick to a budget. So start with what's called a zero-based budget. That means every dollar is accounted for. So every single dollar, so you make, you know, $1,000 a month, all $1,000 of that income are accounted for. Whether that's in savings, whether that's in fixed or flexible expenses, whether that's in fund money, whether that's in whatever it is, there's at the end of that month, you should know where every single one of those dollars went. And so when you start running into problems is when you create what's called a more than zero-based budget, where you have only $900 accounted for, and that extra $100 that could have been spent more wisely or could have been saved, it just kind of, you know, where it went. So you want to have a zero-based budget. That said, that doesn't mean that you plan out everything to a T and you have no room for a buffer. And so you want to build in that buffer to the point where you like have $50, $100, whatever it is, that you know, like, okay, car breaks down, I get sick, whatever it is, I have a buffer that's going to enable me to kind of pull money out and still stay within my budget. Now, obviously, there's, you know, things that are going to extend beyond that buffer, and that's what the emergency fund is for. And so you want to be able to stay within your budget while still being accountable for every dollar. The next thing is to track your spending electronically. So all of us have bank statements and bank cards and stuff like that. But it's kind of hard to scroll through your statements to kind of figure out exactly where your money's going, just because it gets a little confusing. So there's multiple apps that do a really good job. I myself use Mint. Mint is a free online like tool. It has an app on your phone. You can connect it to your bank account. and it'll basically keep track of all your assets. So you can go in there and you can create a budget saying, I want to spend $100 on groceries this month. I want to spend $50 on gas, et cetera, et cetera. And you can see every time you make a purchase, it'll kind of like fill in those categories of where you are and keep you up to date. Another one is Every Dollar. This is Dave Ramsey's tool. It's basically the same thing as Mint, except you can't connect it to your bank accounts. You have to do it manually, which is has some pros and cons, keeps you more proactive about it because you're thinking about it. I'm at, you know, go edit my budget, but also you can forget about it. So a couple things there. On the flip side, you can use an envelope system, so remove the electronic system entirely. The pros of that is that studies have shown that if you use hard cash, you're less likely to spend money. Because something about us, like handing a bill to someone, especially a bigger bill, just we don't like doing that. We can see the money leaving us. So if you use an envelope system where everything is paper, you're just gonna be a lot more frugal naturally. And so also it's very easy, like, okay, I have a grocery envelope, I have a fun envelope, I have a, you know, mortgage envelope, and you can just kind of pull money out of each envelope, so it's pretty effective. But also just very old fashioned, and not everyone likes carrying envelopes with them everywhere. So yeah, those are some practical tips. Another thing is keeping your goals in mind. So if you have a goal, I want to buy a new car, I want to have a 3-month emergency fund set up, keep that in mind. So you want to know, you want to be on track with your savings, and that'll kind of motivate you to keep with the budget. Another thing that I've found really effective is forced savings. What I mean forced savings is basically having something where it's really hard to get that money out of. And so an app I use is called Acorns. Acorns is actually a stock market like app. It's what's called an ETF, electronic trade fund. But what it is, you connect it to your bank account, and every time you make a purchase, it takes the loose change of that purchase. So let's say it's $1.50, it takes that 50 cents up to $2, invests it in your stock market portfolio. So I have a moderate portfolio, so it's fairly aggressive, has some stocks, has some bonds, has some a couple different things. You can make it really aggressive, so it's all stock. You can make it really conservative, so it's all bonds. And it gets a little more into investing. But the point is that it takes money that normally you forget about, like 50 cents spare change, and puts it somewhere where it's gonna grow naturally over time. And also it's kind of hard to access. Like, you can't access it. So I could go right now and pull out all of my Acorns account. That said, I wouldn't get that money for about a week. And so if I'm in a pinch, I wanna buy something, that gives me a week where I can't get that money. And so it's a lot harder to access. So I have to, it's basically forcing me to save, because every time I swipe my card, that change that I would normally like not care about is going towards a savings account, so to speak. So that's one thing I found to be a little more effective this semester, and then just keep trying. So Dave Ramsey says that it usually takes at least 3 times with adjusting your budget before you kind of at least even feel like you are budgeting, because it's really hard to do. So if you fail the first time, try again, and you'll get better at it. So here's my personal example. So this is a work in progress. This is this semester. So right now, with $550 a month, about 100 of that goes to auto transport, so gas, parking, entertainment, Netflix, Spotify, movies, shopping, groceries. This is obviously the biggest one. So I'm working on whittling down. I eat a lot of food. That's kind of a problem. So personal maintenance, haircut, dry clean. There's my savings account. So along with the Acorns app, along with the spare change, you can also set up like monthly deposits. So I have $25 that goes towards my Acorns account every month. And it's kind of a forced savings. And then miscellaneous, so that's kind of my buffer. That if any of these areas I happen to go over on, I have the miscellaneous to kind of like provide a little bit of buffer. So this is like an okay example. It's not great. You know, obviously you want to be saving more than 4% of your total income or total manageable money, but it's a, considering I've just gotten really serious with it this year, it's a work in progress, so to speak. So, do you guys have any questions? Yes.
I was gonna say, making a budget off of variable income, just like a lot of like, especially our age, it's hourly jobs, or even more older, like jobs that work off like commission, it's a little bit more difficult to like make a budget off the variable income. So like, what do you recommend for that?
Yeah, so I would say kind of figure out the aggregate. What's your average? So over 2 months, where was your middle? 3 months, where was your middle? And kind of just figure it out in the middle. Like, what just generally are you gonna make, you know?
Do you like recommend like creating a bigger buffer zone?
Yeah, just make a bigger buffer zone there. So you make $100 a month, and then next one you make $500, put it at like 250, so you can have that bigger buffer zone, and then you have a rule like, okay, if I make $100 extra, that $100 is going towards this savings account or this, you know, kind of purchase or something like that, you know? And so account for every dollar, but only rely upon a certain amount, if that makes sense. You know, try and keep your expenses, your fixed and variable expenses, to what you know you're gonna get. Have the rest of it kind of flexible to go wherever it could go.
Okay.